Growing up, I loved to watch TV. I especially loved to watch how TV families would interact with each other. My favorite family, hands down, all time on TV, are the Tanners from Full House. I love how they would get into an argument or they would have a real serious moment, and then they would just talk it out for a few seconds and everybody would be back to being happy. Everything would be back to being fine. But that's not the truth in most of our families. As I got older, I began to realize that most families in this world have tension, they have secrets, and they have brokenness. So when you hear this, you think about your family and you think, that's my family. My family is broken. My family has fractures. So the question is, how do we face a fractured family? This past Wednesday, we talked about a family that brings hope to those of us who feel like our families are so broken that God could never use. In the middle of Hebrews, the book written to Christians to help push them forward in their faith in a difficult time, we see this verse. It is by faith Isaac promised blessings for the future of his sons, Jacob and Esau. And when you read this, you think this is a special TV dad moment where he gets to pass blessings along, unless you know the history, unless you know the story of Jacob and Esau. Abraham, the one that God promised would be a father of the nation, the one that God promised he would have many descendants follow after him, passed that blessing along to his son Isaac. Isaac then had two sons, Esau and Jacob. And when he was at the end of his life, he was going to pass that blessing on to Esau. So he called Esau in and asked him to prepare a meal and to come meet with him. But when his wife Rebekah heard this, she felt that Jacob would be a better leader for her family. So she decided that they were going to trick Isaac into giving him the blessing. The one catch was Esau had hairy arms and Jacob didn't. So what did Jacob do? He actually did this, put animal hair on his arms. He went in with the food to Isaac, who had poor eyesight, and it actually worked. Isaac passed the blessing on to Jacob. But you can just imagine the tension this would cause in the family, so much so that Esau said he was going to murder his brother. So Jacob was sent off to live with his uncle. It makes our families look a little more normal, right? So how can God use a family that's so broken? The truth is, God can use your family's reality for His purpose. So today you're going to be talking about how do we go from being a part of the problem to being a part of God's solution.